What does it say about this team that you can beat a good Dallas Mavericks team without three starters?
Just next man mentality. I talked about it earlier today and said that, you know, guys are willing to step up, and we got a lot of guys on our team, a lot of depth. So, you know, it just shows that we're a team that's resilient, like I said last year, and it's carrying over into this year.
Why are you feeling more comfortable? Is it just as simple as experience, or is there anything else there?
Experience, trust in my work that I put in this summer, put in a lot of work this summer, and was very dedicated to just, you know, making myself better in ways that'll help the team. And, you know, a lot of film study, listening to what coach has to say, and, you know, my teammates trusting me as well. I think it's just a mixture of all that and, you know, came out to, you know, this season.
Yeah, Dyson, I mean, first real minutes tonight. You know, gets thrown in there against Luka. Just what do you think about the poise he showed tonight?
That's tough, man. He's 19 years old, which is crazy to me. I was at Rice University at 19. Promise you I wasn't guarding anybody in the NBA. So it just shows how, like, advanced he is. And, you know, super proud of him in the minutes that he contributed this evening.
Yeah, going 8 of 8 from the field, just how locked in were you tonight on the offensive end?
Really, it was just whenever I had daylight to shoot the ball, you know, trusting my work once again. I can shoot the ball pretty well, so, you know, just following the same mechanics I always do.
And a second straight game for CJ with 10-plus assists. What do you think about the way he's been facilitating on offense?
It's been a beautiful thing to see, I'll say that. I mean, makes it a lot easier for him to score if he's able to, you know, trust us and be able to get us open shots, because then they can't help as much as they would like to because they're worried about us shooting. So it's really twofold, and it helps him a lot, open up the court for him, and, you know, gets us going as well.
What did you think about the team effort you guys did on Luka late? Seemed like a lot of those threes that he was putting up late were just kind of falling short a little bit.
Nah, definitely. It was a wear-down effect. I mean, just listening to the game plan discipline. Najee did a great job on the point of attack. And, you know, everybody else chipped in as a collective, just helped out and found ways to, you know, just slow him down because he's ahead of the snake. He's a great player. But we definitely had a team effort tonight on trying to slow down Luka Doncic.
How big was it for you guys to come out with the 40-point first quarter, and especially after the way the last game ended?
Humongous. I mean, they're a big first quarter team. They come out and punch people in the mouth really quickly. And so we just had to sustain their runs and also just play with a lot of force. We play with a lot of energy in the first quarter. And, you know, I think that's what helped us and carried it over to the rest of the game.
Trey, have you had a game before where you didn't miss a shot, like going back to junior high or
Sacramento last year? Yeah. Yeah, no, I didn't miss one. Yeah.
I wonder if you could just comment on having 8 players and reach double figures in scoring. What was the vibe like among the team on the floor? I mean, you talked a little bit about the intensity, but it seemed like a really all hands on deck type of approach.
It was just a fun game, man. Everybody was involved. There was a lot of great energy on the court, a lot of great energy on the bench, man. I just really love being a part of this team because everybody understands it's a we score mentality, and just shows with the amount of people that are in double figures, and we're just super proud and just super happy to be a part of this team.
Speaking of 8 guys in double figures, what did you think of just kind of the tone that Jose set in the first quarter, scoring that he had?
Nah, he was all over the place. Jose is an energizer bunny, and even when he had his injury, he was still running around and just playing as hard as he can, and he sparks our team. He's a great spark plug for us, and he gives us a lot of energy for sure.
You guys had a stretch in the fourth quarter where it went from they were up, Mavs were up a little bit, to you guys had, you know, 7-8 point lead. During that stretch, Devontae made a couple huge plays. I mean, what did you think of what he contributed in crunch time?
I mean, it just shows who Devontae is. He's playing a lot of big-time games, and he's also contributed at a high level to our team. And, you know, we're just thankful for every player on our team. And, you know, Devontae was one of those guys that stepped in and made big plays for us as well down the stretch.
I know you're personally not guarding Jose at practice, but is he, like, a pain to practice against?
I mean, we could throw it back to even college when I used to play him at Virginia. I hated playing against Jose. He was just so annoying. And so I couldn't stand him. Even my parents and my cousins, they couldn't stand him. So that just shows what type of player he was. And now that he's on my team, I just love him to death, man. I love playing with Jose. So, You know, he's one of those players where it's like you hate to play against him, love to have him on your team, and, you know, everybody needs one of those guys on their team.
Thanks, Trey. Thanks.
Yep.